Today I'm going to be demonstrating the various features and capabilities of DiscoveryBot. And to begin, I'm going to show how DiscoveryBot helps you to start with automation and how it can help capture user processes. But before I begin to show you any of this, I want to preface with a hypothetical DiscoveryBot use case. So picture that you want to kick off automation in your HR team with some simple but manual task. And this task involves enrolling employees into a benefit program with a local gym. But since the membership database used by the gym isn't integrated with your HR system, the team must receive info about employees and then manually fill out that info into a web form to enroll each employee. Now, this task sounds like an appropriate use case for RPA, but to really determine the feasibility of automation, you need to see exactly how this task is executed down to every click and keystroke. And in a traditional work setting, what you would have to do is that you have to sit down with the HR operations team and ask them to show you how the process is done step by step and document the steps manually, making it a very time and human resource intensive process. So with DiscoveryBot, you can do all of this automatically just by observing a user's computer actions. And now I'm going to dive in to see how this all actually works. So before a user begins to record, an admin must first create a project in DiscoveryBot and invites the HR team to record their actions while executing this task. But for time's sake today, we've already done that step and we're just going to go right into recording the process. So let's go ahead and log into the system. And then we can go to the recording section. And then once we're in the recording section, we can go find the right project, which in this case is benefits, and click on start recording. So once we've clicked on start recording, we'll see a box that'll pop up momentarily. And once that box is popped up, that's how you know that DiscoveryBot is now ready to capture user actions. So here in this part, you can see that this part of the process involves receiving this email with an attached file and the list of employees to enroll in the benefit program. So let's go ahead and save that file and then open it. And then once it's opened, you'll be able to see that it's a pretty simple Excel table. There's a couple different attributes for different employees. So we have first name, last name, employee ID, and job title. So this is information that we're going to submit into the web form that I've pulled up just now. So in this web form, what we're going to do is that we're going to carefully copy and paste each of the items into this corresponding web form field. So right now we just did Greg, and now we're going to go to the last name, which is Garcia. So once we've pasted Garcia, then we can go on to the third column and then paste the employee ID. And then so on and so forth for each of the cells in this row. So then we'll go ahead and paste in the last item as well, and then go ahead and submit the form. So now that we've filled out the first form, we can go ahead and stop the recording. And once the recording is stopped, we can go back to DiscoveryBot, and then we can go ahead and click on the recording section to review this recording. So we can see in here that we can see a bunch of different recordings from different trials and different users. And here we can see that the individual actions that were recorded along with the applications, the actions were performed on. So we can see how I opened the email, found this attachment in the email, saved the attachment, and all these other steps. And all the data which we typed into the keyboard is also saved into the recording. So you can make, you can review these keystrokes and then make adjustments if necessary. And another thing you could do if that there's any extraneous steps that we don't want in the final recording, we can remove them as well, like how I'm doing now. So another thing we can do is also provide additional notes to give context to the process analyst to understand what happens in the step from each process. So this, what it does is that it gives the user context and allows them to better understand what's really going on in the process. So now that the recording looks complete, we've submitted it. And then after we submit it, it goes for further review where the RPA team can analyze the recordings and then turn them into an automation opportunity. So with all these recording features, DiscoveryBot makes it easy to collect the process details from business users and then transfer this information to the automation team.